So tell us what you're feeling.
I feel like it's almost like I have to combine the pelvic motion with the trunk motion now. Whereas before they were separated. So I'm kind of shifting my whole trunk in, utilizing the pelvis to kind of keep my set.
Over the hip, yeah. Right? Yeah. So you're kind of moving trunk and pelvis over the hip here.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Cool. So the hip is punctum fixum now.
Yes.
Cool.
As I go back, I'm feeling myself able to kind of use that foot support.
Any hip muscles you feel?
It feels like I'm kind of centered in my hip.
Great.
So it feels like it's a little bit of everything. It's not one particular spot.
But you're centrated on your hip.
Yeah, on my stance leg.
Cool. Let's see your stance leg. Mm-hmm.
Just like you were saying, the point of the finger kind of feels like it's at like the acetabular joint.
It's centrated.
Yeah. My foot helps me go back. And yeah.
What if you try to bring your trunk forward?
Okay. Yeah, if I move just the trunk, I can definitely do this. It's easier, but it's still hard to isolate the pelvis away from that because as I shift my trunk, mm-hmm. the rocker board moves, so I have to stay.
So it sort of feels like you're doing what you did when your 2 feet were on the ground, but now it's harder because it's over the right hip.
Yeah, and it also feels combined. So regardless of the markers, with markers being on my shoulders before, with both feet on the ground, I felt like I was just isolating my upper trunk while keeping my pelvis fixed. Mm-hmm. And now it feels like I have to combine the pelvic isolation plus the upper trunk isolation in order to move. Like I can't separate.
You move them together, you can't isolate.